An algorithm has been written in pseudocode to generate 50 positive random integers with values less than or equal to 100. These random integers are stored in the array randNum. The function randx, y generates a random integer greater than or equal to x and less than y. For example, rand 1,4 generates 1 or 2 or 3. Question B says, the pseudocode for this algorithm could be shortened by the use of a for next loop. Rewrite the algorithm using a for next loop. We've been given pseudocode that contains a repeat until loop that is going to loop 50 times, generating an array of random numbers between 1 and 100. We want to take this repeat until loop and turn it into a for loop. A repeat until loop is known as a condition controlled loop. A for loop is known as a count controlled loop. There are two ways we can approach this answer. The first is to take the pseudocode and convert it into a for loop. The second is just to write out the answer from this description using a for loop. There is also a third option, which is to use both approaches, where we take information from the question and also lines from the pseudocode. Let's do this third option. The question has told us that we need to generate 50 integers. In the pseudocode, you can see that we are repeating 50 times. The count starts at 0 and ends when the count is greater than or equal to 50. Inside the loop, we're increasing or incrementing the count by 1 on each iteration. This code, count is set to count plus 1, increases the current value of count by 1. A for loop does these three steps, all in a single line. Let's write those three steps out. The first is to initialize the count variable. The second is to check if this count variable is equal to the stop value. The stop value in this case is 50. And the third step is to increment the count, usually by 1. If we look at the structure of a for loop, we can see that it does these three steps in one line. It initializes the count variable, it checks if the count variable is equal to the stop value, and it increments the count variable every time it loops around. We can take the structure and we can simply substitute the start and the stop values that have been given in order to loop 50 times. We can say for count starting at 0, as 0 as the initial value. However, we cannot say that it stops at 50. And the reason for this is because of the loop number compared to the count number. Let's quickly speak about this. The loop number refers to the number of times the for loop has currently iterated. On the first iteration of the for loop, the value of count is going to be 0 based on the values we gave it. We loop back to the beginning and we begin our second loop. When we loop back to the beginning, we also increment count by 1, so count becomes 1. We get to the end and we loop back to the beginning, starting our third loop, meaning we increment count by 1. What you might be able to see is that the count variable is 1 less than the current loop number. If we continue this trend all the way up to our 50th loop, we'll see that the count only reaches 49, and it does not reach 50. The question told us that we want to generate 50 numbers, so we only want to loop 50 times. But that must mean that the count needs to stop at 49. So instead of writing 50, the loop needs to stop when count reaches 49. Remember that with pseudocode, when count reaches 49, it will still execute whatever is in the for loop for the last time. We can close our for loop using the next keyword and the variable we created for the counter. This is going to be count. And inside the for loop, we can simply copy and paste what is written in the pseudocode. Remember that we don't need to write down count is set to count plus 1 because the for loop does this automatically based on these three steps. Question 3 says, identify another loop structure available in pseudocode. We've used a for loop. We've used a repeat until loop. The last loop available to us is a while loop. Another answer we could give here would be a precondition loop. Since a repeat until loop is known as a postcondition loop, a for loop is a count controlled loop, a while loop is then a precondition loop. But there we go, that is this question completed.